Something happened at the hotel. Something happened at the hotel. We had a quarrel in our room, didn't we?
Something happened at the hotel.
We had a quarrel in our hotel room, didn't we? Something happened at the hotel. We had a quarrel in our room, didn't we? I said things that you probably thought I regretted the next day that I didn't really mean. I said things that you thought that I hadn't really meant. That you probably thought I regretted the next day that I hadn't really meant. Since I said no more about them. Since I said no more about them. Said no more about them and just packed my things. Just packed my things. And went with you to the helicopter. Where I carefully placed my skis and equipment. To the helicopter. Went with you to the helicopter where I carefully placed my skis. Placed my skis and equipment in the requisite box on the helicopter side. Climbed into on the helicopter side. Climbed into the cabin. Climbed into on the helicopter side. Climbed into. Climbed into the cabin and politely greeted the two Dutch tourists. Who were flying out and politely greeted. And the two Dutch tourists who were flying out to the same area and whom we planned to accompany for a couple of days. Whom we planned to accompany. To accompany for a couple of days until you got the idea. Ruining your trip, and you wanted us to go in. Ruining our trip, you got the idea. You got the idea. You got the idea that you wanted us to go. That you wanted us to go alone. And I walked behind you for the next few days, right behind you. But part of you never left that hotel room. Walked behind you, right behind you, never left that hotel room. Behind you, right behind you, part of me. Behind you, right behind you, never left. Always dragging behind you, each time you forgot to ask what I wanted. Each time you forgot to ask what I wanted. If I was alright, you forgot to ask. You forgot to ask. You forgot to ask. I went anyway. Always dragging behind you. And each time a part of me detached itself. Each time a part of me detached itself was strewn on the ground. A part of me detached itself strewn on the ground. The ground behind me, the ground behind me, and over these last days here in Greenland, there's not been much left of me. These last days, but you haven't noticed. And if you don't know what that means, check in the International Code for Signals. But you can't even see it, which is why you're surprised. You can't even see it. Which is why you're surprised. Which is why you're surprised when I suddenly leave you. Suddenly leave you. Leave you a few days later. A few days later, one after another. And I've wanted to tell you something. I've wanted to tell you something all day, and began to think that it could still work. That we have
I'm about to talk with you to open the subject when you interrupt to open the subject when you interrupt to say you have the timing.
And you ask if I'm just going to bloody stand there and be useless. And I just go on standing there and watch you fumble with a candle. Standing there and watch you fumble with a
candle.
You get hot and you take off your jacket. Take off your jacket. Put it on the snow next to you before crawling into the tent to assemble the skeleton that will make the tent stand upright, and the canvas muffles the sound as the final piece detaches itself from me. Muffles the sound, muffles the sound, the sound. The sound as the final piece detaches itself from me. Now I'm only the tiniest part human being. All that's left are my legs. And I pick up your jacket and go. Start to run, and it's some time before you notice. You hear nothing from inside the tent. And when you finally crawl out backwards and turn around several times confused, you conclude, I've just gone a little way down the plateau for a pee. And you think nothing more of it before an hour has passed, maybe two. Not until you've finally got the tent up. You still can't see it. But see my tracks heading in a straight line eastwards. And then you start to follow me. Before you give up and turn back, you turn back. Then, as you crawl into the tent, you notice that you're cold. That your jacket is gone, and that you've already started to freeze. That you discover that I've stuffed the sleeping bags with snow. And that they're too wet to lie in, and that I have the matches from the propane stove. Almost a mile to the east, I've stopped running, started to walk.